So in today's video, we're doing a catch cook. I'm going from here to here. This is the Costa Creek catch cook. What is going on? I have a pretty cool video today. This is my Costa Creek catch and cook. I've had this idea for quite a while, actually. And what I'm doing, there is a creek on the way to the coast that has crawdads, and I want to go and catch some of those, along with making a fish sandwich from catching, hopefully, a rockfish from the coast here. I'm here in Florence, my least favorite beach there is, and I'm not too optimistic about catching fish here, but I do have a backup plan just in case I don't. It is super, super windy right now, and it's cold, and the water is rough, so I might not catch anything. And I'm preparing myself for that because I don't feel like it's going to happen. There's really not a whole lot of stuff online about people catching fish here because it's not known for its fishing. That's Newport. Unfortunately, this is the coast closest to me and also on the way to that creek that I want to crawdad in. I got my fish gear. I got all the cooking stuff I need, and I'm going to be cooking out of the back of the fishing mobile right here. So I'm gonna grab my stuff, get ready, and we're gonna head down the jetty and see if we can get some fish. Hopefully not break off a bunch, but I think that's gonna happen. I'm actually going to call it out here already. I've only been out here for an hour and a half, but it is, as you can tell, super windy, really cold, and the water is really rough, and the tide is just slopping in real fast. I'm still kind of learning how to read all this water and how to fish at the right time, and I keep breaking off. All these jetty rocks are just coated in barnacles, and it is just tearing everything up. So this is why people say go to Newport. So if you're gonna fish for rockfish, don't come here. So that's my advice for today. Florence sucks. So, with that being said, I'm gonna change step one to this. Thank you. Well, was I able to put my skills to the test and catch out in Florence, maybe Newport next time, but I did get the next best thing. Bought a rockfish fillet, so this will be part of the sandwich, but I will catch some crawdads, I will. All right, now that step one is done of the fish taco experience, I am at the new location to get the crawdads. I am at Whittaker Creek. It's actually right behind me. It's a really awesome place. One of my favorite spots. I've been going here since I was in middle school. So I have my net, I got a bucket, got a mask and some swim shorts, and I'm gonna get under and do step two of this awesome catch and cook. Here we go. So I'm down the spot I'm gonna jump in at. I'm going right down there, right in this little pool. It's cold, but it's kind of cool coming back here to do a catch and cook, because the very first video I ever did on this channel like 2 years ago was a catch and cook here. I went to Florence and I got a crab and came down here and got some crawdads. So it's kind of crazy to see how far I've come in those 2 years and how much my equipment's kind of stepped up. So gonna be doing that again. Got my stuff right there. I'm gonna hop in, switch into the GoPro. I'm not afraid to die. Alright, so now that we have our nice little creek lobsters, it's time to get to the next step of this delicious sandwich.
Let's get it.
All right, now that we have our water boiling, we want to season it with a little bit of Old Bay's. Now it's time to start plopping these little lobsters in, one at a time. But before I do so, I'm going to rinse them off a little bit with some fresh water. I meant to purge them, but I didn't, which kind of gets the gross stuff out. But one at a time. Bye-bye. Let these boil for about 5 minutes or so. This should be just the right amount of time to get that fully cooked. These two were too small in my opinion, so I'm gonna go let them go. So I got about six in there. That should be just enough for the little lobster salad. All right, crawdads are just about done. I'm gonna turn it off and I'm going to take them out and let them cool. And then we're gonna start working on the next part of this meal. So when the crawdads are done, they should be turning this beautiful red right there. That sure looks tasty. All right, now that my crawdads are done cooking, I'm gonna get to my next step, which is making the crawdad salad, lobster salad, kind of my take on it, that's gonna go on the fish sandwich. I'm gonna go over what's going in this real quick. First thing going in is some mayo, some pickle, chives, lemon, celery, some rice vinegar, capers, and I'm putting a little bit of, I know this looks a little weird, but some lemon basil. Then just some seasonings I have, like I'm gonna have garlic powder, Old Bay's, and some of this Johnny's seafood seasoning. So I've made up my little, the base of this without adding the crawdads yet. So that's what it's come out with. It's mayo, all the other like little things I added. It tastes really good so far. Now is the next step, and here it is. I'm gonna show you how to clean these real quick. They're very easy to clean. This one's still a little hot. But pretty much what I'm gonna be eating is this right here, which is the tail, and a little bit out of the claws. But they're just like lobsters, so you're going to want to separate the tail from the head. Just grab and pull. Boom, easy like that. Just got the head there. From here, you're going to have your tail. You're going to have these two legs right here, and there's all these segmented pieces. So you want to take where those legs are, and you're going to just snap that. And this little top piece where those legs are should slide right off like that, see? So you just cracked it, and then you're gonna wanna pinch right there and grab the meat and just pull slightly, and there you go. There is your one little piece of crawdad. Right here is gonna be some where you can grab to devein it like that. So you're gonna take, that's where all the intestines and the poop go. So you just discard that piece, and you're left with this tasty little morsel. And that's gonna go right into the little salad I'm gonna make. So that is all the crawdad meat we have. It's not a lot, but it will do. I gotta hurry up and make the sandwich. I am running out of daytime. All right, there is the crawdad salad. That is good. I'm gonna throw that on ice, cook the fish, and we'll be good to go. All right, on to the next step. So we are going to toast our buns and cook our fish, and we will be donezo. That on here. Got our buns nice and toasted. Alright, so there's gonna be some bone right about here that we're not gonna want. So I'm just gonna cut that piece off. Alright, then I'm gonna season these real quick with some salt and pepper. Turn up the heat. Alright, that's cooking and ready to go. Time to lay our pieces of fish on our tackle box plate on the bun. Get the rest of that butter on there. Yeah. Whew, yeah. Look at that. But wait. Can't forget a good healthy slathering of our crawdad salad on top of this amazing fish. That chives, crawdad, pickle, capers. There you go. This is an amazing frickin' sandwich right here. This is true Costa Creek. This is awesome. This crawdad was caught maybe like an hour ago. This fish caught not too long ago either. All cooked right here. That's all she wrote. Awesome. This is sweet. I love this. There you have it. Fish and crawdad sandwich, Costa Creek. Went to Florence, came down to Whittaker Creek, got some fish, got some crawdad, made this amazing sandwich right out of the back of my car. That is sweet. Look at that thing, that looks awesome. Time for the true test. I made this I made this recipe up like a day and a half ago, so I'm super excited. It is juicy as hell. Oh my God. Holy crap. Talk about. Yeah. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. This was a lot of freaking fun. Please help me get to 500 subs. If you haven't followed my Instagram, Instagram's right here. I hope you make this sandwich. This is freaking insane. This is a lot better than I thought it was gonna be. Wow. Don't forget, I brought a lemon. Squeeze some lemon on there. It is amazing. I hope to catch you and some delicious fish in the next video. Thanks very much. See ya. Peace. Oh my God, it's freaking amazing. Gosh. Camera's still on. Whoops.